At the end of every race, you feel very accomplished. You know, you feel like all your hard work's really paid off. But finishing Deccan Cliffhanger made me extremely proud. Ready to go!
Cycle and the sense of freedom, the sense of strength you get, that's what cycling is about.
Cycling is the strength of my life.
So the Deccan Cliffhanger is a 640-kilometer race that goes from Pune to Goa. People who finish the Deccan Cliffhanger route solo qualify to race across America, which is a 5,000-kilometer race.
It feels good to know that there are females who are coming across and wanting to do and give it out, that yes, we are here.
I started the Deccan Cliffhanger race in 2014 after going for crewing at Race Across America a couple of times. The idea of Deccan Cliffhanger at that time was to create an event over here that would bring in people, give a good training ground for people who are aspiring for Race Across America.
Divya has done a swell job of putting together a really killer route, literally and figuratively.
Climbs after climbs after climbs. And that too in the sun is really challenging.
Over the years, what I've seen is that's not what it's all about. Deccan Cliffhanger is an aspirational race for people who are not even ever going to think about racing across America. People who have just started cycling can attempt to do it. I have seen people who have crewed for other people in a race or two and never cycled before decide that in the next year they want to cycle this race.
My introduction to serious cycling started when I participated as a crew member when my husband, Captain Mahesh Zog, was a member team of four. He participated in Deccan Cliffhanger.
My name is Manasri Baheti and I'm 16 years old now. This is my second time doing the Deccan Cliffhanger because I did it once last year. So I'm really excited to do this again.
Race ke pehle ka jo day tha, वो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा. उसके वाइफ वाइब्रेशंस बहुत अच्छे थे, वहाँ के सब लोग बहुत
कोऑपरेटिव थे. द रेस हैज बीन ग्रोइंग स्लोली इन टर्म्स ऑफ वुमेन पार्टिसिपेशन. In the first year, we had Shusanah Pillinger from UK take part in RAAM qualifier solo, and she actually won the race. And there were myself, Ila, and another girl who took part in the relay teams. And the second edition didn't see any women taking part at all. Third edition was finally the breakthrough moment where Sanya, the first woman from India to attempt a RAAM qualification, she took part in solo.
My journey with cycling started with Deccan Cliffhanger. I officiated for the first edition and I crewed in the second edition, and then I just thought that, yay, let's put myself through this kind of pain. So I decided to do a solo ride in DC third edition. I didn't think I knew what I was getting into, but at that point of time I just thought it would be a lot of fun, and it was a lot of fun. Unfortunately, I was not able to finish for various reasons, but it was still a very valuable experience in my life.
In the fourth edition of Deccan Cliffhanger, we had three women attempting solo, and out of which Ila Patil finished the RAAM qualification timings and qualified for Race Across America, the first woman and as of now the only woman from India to have qualified.
I have been associated with this race right from its first edition, and year after year somewhere I was crewing, sometime I was officiating, and after 3 years I realized that okay, now it's time for me to go solo. It was challenging for me because I had never done such a, you know, 30 plus hour ride before.
Finally this year we had 4 solo and 12 women in the relay teams.
So the Deccan Cliffhanger is done, and it honestly still feels a little surreal that I've actually finished the race. I've actually cycled for 643 kilometers. The experience of it was unbelievable. It is by far one of the toughest things I've ever done.
Out of the four women who took part, Saloni from Pune and Jyoti from Nagpur managed to finish the Inspire India timings of for Deccan Cliffhanger. Saloni finished a little over that time and Jyoti finished a few hours later. Neither of them has qualified for RAAM, but I think they both took joy in having faced that challenge and reached the finish line.
DC ने मुझे काफी कुछ लाइफ में सिखाया है, एक सीख दी है कि कभी हारो मत, उम्मीद मत छोड़ो. ठीक है इस बार नहीं आना था देयर इज ऑलवेज सेकेंड टाइम
द अदर टू दीपांति एंड हितिशा At some point, they decided to quit the race. Perhaps the challenge was a bit too much for them. I hope to see them back again next year.
I started my training for Deccan Cliffhanger somewhere around here in the month of April, May. And I was really new into the field of bicycling. But yes, it was very exhausting. I had to put in everything that I had. And the biggest challenge as well that was there was becoming fitter from becoming 90 kgs to going to 65 kgs for Deccan Cliffhanger.
I was really been inspired by Kabir Achure, who has been doing a lot of endurance biking and racing, and he kind of got me into this that you have been riding quite often now and why don't you just try this event. So frankly, I'm not prepared for it, I've not done anything for it, but here I am trying to see how I go for myself so I understand where do I stand.
We had two women relaying in a team in which they also, their entire crew was also all women. So it was truly an all-women team. In that, Meera and Megha were the racers, and they managed to finish a little outside of their time. But I think the entire group had a great time doing Deccan Cliffhanger.
I'm feeling very excited for my crew. They enjoyed it. We enjoyed it. It was a very challenging route, and I mean, no regrets of finishing 2 hours. After the cutoff, it was a wonderful race.
So within the mixed teams, we had a lot of women taking part in various different team sizes, and in the two-person team, Arpita Gupta finished very well in her category.
I participated in a relay team of two players, so me and my partner Aruni Utkarsh. This is my first DC attempt and my first endurance race ever. It was fun.
Then we had team Ubuntu with Lina Shende. They were the first of the mixed teams to reach the finish line. And then in the tandem team, we had two women taking part, one as a stoker and one as a pilot. One of the youngest participants that we have, Manasvi, who is visually challenged, and Nupur, who has been a pilot for the Adventures Beyond Barriers.
I'll see you in Bogmalo at the beach having a beer.
I think everyone who gets to that finish line should feel extremely proud because it's not easy.
And today after playing, I was just waiting for this moment and I'm just cherishing this moment.
Very great sense of achievement.
Come on.
It was very hot today, so the last stretch was a killer.
Yeah.
But the anticipation of reaching on time made us push.
I feel like a boss. I remember thinking of all the things that I'm going to eat after the race. Like, you burn 20,000 calories,
Thank you a lot to Inspire India for organizing such races and so well managed and such a good team.
What DC has given me is, it has definitely given me a huge hope on myself. I am not giving up on myself and I'm gonna give it a shot again.
Special thanks to Divya, who always encourages women participants to be part of Deccan Cliffhanger. I believe if I could start at the age of 45, it is possible for every girl and every woman.
Deccan Cliffhanger has become one of the most celebratory races in India right now. It's like a big cycling celebration.
You feel like the queen of the world!
मेरा इंटरव्यू चल रहा है बॉम्बिंग कर रहे हैं क्या पुट दिस इन द फिल्म